Hi, I'm Zach Walchuk, Technical Content Lead at Resin.io. We recently released support for multi-container applications, which offer, among other things, an easy way to manage services individually. I'm going to demonstrate how to deploy a multi-container application and update a single service, but first, let's look at the equipment the application will be running on. I'm using a Raspberry Pi 3 Model B, an Adafruit 2.8-inch Pi TFT screen, which goes on top of my Raspberry Pi, and finally a microSD card flashed with the latest version of Resin OS. Once I insert my SD card and power up, I'll see my device appear in the Resin.io dashboard and begin downloading the application containers, which were already built for me when I pushed my code to the application earlier. To learn more about these setup steps, check out docs.resin.io/getting-started. As you can see on the dashboard, my application has four services, each packaged into a separate container. While the containers download onto my device, let's take a closer look at how the services are set up. Multi-container projects on resin.io need a docker-compose.yml file at the root of the project to define the services that make up the application. In this case, we have a front-end server that generates static web content, a data service that reads CPU temperature and puts it on a WebSocket, and a proxy service that routes traffic from port 80 on the host OS to the appropriate services. We also have a GUI service running a lightweight HTML5 browser to render the web page. Unlike single-container applications, multi-container applications do not run containers as privileged by default. This allows containers to be run in isolation, with access to system resources granted individually. In this application, you can see that only the GUI service is given access to the display devices. The application has finished downloading onto the device and has started running. I notice that the data on the display does not match what I would expect. Looking at the code, I see I've made a typo. Once I correct this, I git add and commit my changes and push to the application. Because the change was made to the data service, only that container is built and downloaded. And with that quick fix, the application is now running correctly. If you're ready to build your own, check out the link in the description below for more information and the source code of this project.